Do you ever have the debate with yourself, oh, I wish I lived by a beach so I could put my toes in the sand every day, listen to that water, relax in the sun? Or are you the type of person that prefers to be curled up in a nice fuzzy blanket on the couch watching movies in a dark, cozy, tight room? Well, that was the poll that I had this week. Every Sunday on Instagram, I put up some pictures and I have people pick which room they like better, which vibe they like better, which plants they like better, which decor they like better. It's just a fun game to start to envision what you're trying to manifest in your dream home or on your dream vacation. And this poll this week was a home movie theater or home warm lagoon. I got smart this week. This is the third video in this series, and normally I just put up the picture with the poll results, but I'm gonna put a box over it. Here's the picture, and before I show you the results, comment below which one you prefer, A for the cozy in-home theater, or B for the home lagoon. Okay, did you comment below? Now I'm gonna remove it. Here are the results. I keep looking down for, I actually have the picture and the results here. As you can see on Instagram, the one that won was the home lagoon. People are suckers for a beach. They're sucker for water. They love it. They love the sun. They love the sand. I totally get it. I don't even know if I can decide which one I prefer on this one. For me, my brain starts to think logical in these votes. I'm like, ugh, would I want to deal with all that sand? There looks like there'd be like a lot of bugs around there. I don't think I want that at my home. So I get really into polls. I really analyze it and take it seriously. But in this case, for fun, most people chose the warm home lagoon. Normally in the poll, I'm critiquing each room and I'm telling people which are good tips from each room to apply to their home, maybe certain things and arrangements to avoid. In this case, this is more about the ambiance. Whether you're designing your home, whether you're looking for a new place, whether you're deciding on a vacation to go to, or on a new way to decorate your home, there's a few things that you can consider to help you know what to invest in or which paint to choose, etc. First, look at your Ming Gua. Your Ming Gua, your personal energy number, there's a link in the description of this video that you can just click, enter your email, and based on your birthday, I made a nice easy chart that shows you what your personal element is. Your personal element and your personal energy number. Each number has an element, whether it be fire, earth, metal, water, or wood, and you can design your home with that concept in mind. Now, to get really, really specific, a feng shui consultant will actually run a calculation. Which way is your home facing? When was it built? What are the birthdays in the home? What's the form? It gets very specific and looks at what energy is present. Is it fire energy? Is it wood energy? So do you need to add in some water to smooth things out? But first, while you're just working at home, applying feng shui on your own, look at what your personal energy number is, the element it's associated with. So for example, if your personal energy number 8, you're an earth element. Fire supports earth. Fire is that sun, it's that warmth. So do you have a nice area outside that's very warm, that charges you, that restores you, that builds you up? Or maybe you're wood. 3s and 4s, you guys are the wood element. And what supports wood is water. Water is dark, it's flowy, so you still have that water. The lagoon might still suit you, but maybe you're somebody who likes the cozy cold to be inspired, to recharge, to then grow with your ideas and your wood attributes and creativity. So maybe you need that dark, alone, introspective time. And so the home movie theater might be more your vibe. Another thing you guys can check out to help you know how to start designing and designing for your energy is looking at your human design. The bottom left arrow on your human design chart, you could go to mybodygraph.com, you can go to myhumandesign.com, get for free your human design chart. The bottom left arrow, if it's pointing to the right, is consistency, and if it's pointing to the left, is variety. And there, you can go check out my Instagram, I created a nice post about it. If you are the consistent arrow, then what's good for you is to have each room or each activity have a designated spot. Don't try and start working from your bedroom. Don't try and combine a bunch of activities into one room. So it might be nice for you to have like an at-home movie theater where you recharge and reset, and then you have like your wild family room or living room more open to the home. If you have the variable, if you have the variety arrow, then you are a little bit more flexible. You get inspired in different areas. So you might need that nature. You might need that outdoor space where you can sit in a few different angles. You can sit amongst different trees. The vegetation's always growing and changing. And so that variety might add to your energy. That's all for the room critiques this week. Obviously, feng shui, you can tell it's so layered. You can see it's so dynamic. There is just so many different ways to look at things and things to variables to consider. And then we have to consider your personal energy. So if you'd like, go follow me on Instagram, subscribe while you're here, like this video if you enjoyed it just a little bit, and stay tuned as more of these videos come out, because some of these tips you can apply to your home, to your energy, so that you can change your life with feng shui.